Yesterday, the Prime Minister, Robina Nabbanja, tabled before Parliament a statement on the fate of the alleged missing opposition supporters whose whereabouts remain unknown. This was in the follow-up of a high-level meeting between the top government officials, security and the opposition this week, which was chaired by Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayebwa. However, Nabbanja only accounted for 5 missing persons as opposed to the 24 people on the opposition's list that was tabled to the government. She blamed the opposition for failure to furnish government with finer details of the victims.
He wrote to me and gave me a list of those people he claims were abducted. And you can see, for example, if you can read, Chibarama John Bosco, abducted on 3rd of June 2019 from Kanyanya, Gayaza Road. Most of them are in Kitalia, Max Papus, for a number of criminal cases.
The opposition in Parliament has come out today to disregard the government's position on missing persons. While addressing the press at Parliament today, the opposition leadership, led by the Shadow Minister of Defence, Jonathan Odu, lashed out at the statement by the Prime Minister on the fate of missing persons, saying it was being treated casually. The opposition cited contradictions in the statement which the Prime Minister tabled before Parliament this week, accounting for only 5 people out of 24.
We have considered the response by government delivered through the Right Honourable Prime Minister Robina Nabbanja on the questions of abductions, illegal detentions and murders of Ugandans over the last 6 months. And we find her statement very casual and very callous, and therefore we have decided to reject it and to dismiss it, and to call on government to be sensitive, to call on government to be responsive, to be concerned about the fate of families of Ugandans who have been abducted, who have been detained, and some of them have lost their lives.
Odu wondered how the government came to confess its own sins by submitting a list of people that have been detained beyond the constitutionally provided time of 48 hours. The opposition called on the government to stop violating the constitution they swore to protect. They have also expressed displeasure with the continued trial of civilians in military courts, especially the general court martial, saying the government is using it for political persecution.
Charged with spreading harmful propaganda, which in its sense has been a provision of the law that had been struck out severally by courts of law, is not a case for the general court martial at any time of the day. We therefore invite the Office of the Attorney General and the Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs to take notice that their office is being used to stamp on the rights of Ugandans, and we think that there must be reforms to that effect.
The opposition also asked the government to account for Mosei Costa Mohonja, who was allegedly arrested from Kasese on the 5th of January and died in detention before he was buried in a cemetery without the knowledge of his relatives. They want the body to be exhumed, taken to Kasese for a decent burial, and his family compensated.
From today going forward, this is going to be business and unusual. You have the body in our Kasese cemetery. You'll have to exhume that body, perform a DNA test, take the body through some medical examination or whatever, a report, especially the scale and scope of torture, a medical report that will be handed over to the family by bedsheets, a blanket, a casket, transport the body to the community. That's number one. And also number two, you will have to ensure that you compensate this particular family.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.